In this video, I'm going to talk about one of the most widely used quantum gate known as the Hadamard gate. Hadamard gate is used in almost all the quantum circuits and in almost all the quantum algorithms. And one of the reasons that people are not able to understand quantum algorithms is because they don't know how to write generalization of Hadamard gate. Although Hadamard gate is a single qubit gate, but we can expand it to apply it on multiple qubits. In this video, I will explain all the things slowly and gradually and clearly. So maybe the length of the video might be a bit longer. Stay tuned. We know that all the quantum gates can be expressed as unitary matrices. And all the qubits can be expressed as vectors. So when we're talking about applying quantum gate on some qubits or some register, then we are only talking about a matrix being multiplied by a vector. So basically, quantum computing is an application of linear algebra. So let's see what is the matrix of Hadamard gate. So Hadamard gate, which we usually express as H, is equals to 1 over square root of 2, and we have here 1, 1, 1, minus 1. Because it is a 2 by 2 matrix, so we can apply this matrix on a single qubit. We know that every qubit, let's say qubit gate size, can be expressed as a vector, which is alpha and beta, where alpha and beta are complex numbers. So we can apply Hadamard gate on this qubit by simply multiplying Hadamard gate with ket psi, and we have our transform qubit ket psi bar. A key use of Hadamard gate is that you give input a qubit in pure state, and Hadamard gate create a qubit in equal superposition. So let's understand it with some examples. So let's say I have a Hadamard gate, and I apply that Hadamard gate on ket 0. Then my answer is going to be ket 0 plus ket 1 divided by square root of 2. That means in this case, my probability of getting 0 was 1. So it is a pure state, where this is an equal superposition. That means I can get either 0 and 1 with same probability, with 0.5 probability. I can get 0 with 0.5 probability, I can get 1 with 0.5 probability. Similarly, if we give Hadamard gate another qubit, let's say ket 1, we will once again get equal superposition, but there might be some phase shift. So we'll get like ket 0 minus ket 1 divided by square root of 2. But this minus sign does not change probabilities, because probabilities are square of amplitude, and minus sign are eliminated when we scale the amplitude. So in this case also, the probability of ket 0 is 0.5, and probability of ket 1 is also 0.5. So Hadamard gate takes input a pure state and create equal superposition. Let me write it down. My goal of this video is to explain everything clearly. So instead of just saying that when Hadamard gate is applied on ket 0, we get this result, I want to show that this result is indeed correct. So let's see that. Now, this is very easy and simple to understand, but I have to show it for everyone so that everyone can understand. We are all on the same page. So I apply Hadamard gate on ket 0. This is basically multiplying this matrix, that matrix represents Hadamard gate, with this vector. And this vector, ket 0, is expressed as a vector whose zeroth location has 1 and all other locations has 0. So zeroth location has 1 and other location has 0. Now we multiply this matrix with this, we get we get here 1 over square root of 2, by the way it should be square root of 2, but we get 1 multiplied by 1 is 1, 1 multiplied by 0 is 0, and then we multiply this by this, we get 1 multiplied by 1 is 1, and minus 1 multiplied by 0 is 0, and then we simplify it, we get 1 over square root of 2, we have here 1, 1. Now, we can write this result in two different vectors. We can write it like this, 1 over square root of 2, and I can write here ket 0, which is 1, 0, and I can write it as ket 1, which is 0, 1. So this vector here represents ket 0, this vector here represents ket 1. And if I add both of those vectors, I will get this result. So then this simplifies to 1 over square root of 2, I have here ket 0 plus ket 1. Or I can simply take 1 over square root 2 underneath it in the denominator for same thing. So I have shown that this result was indeed correct. Similarly, you can yourself try this out, that this result is also correct. Only changes the sign here. As I have explained earlier, that all quantum gates are unitary. The all quantum gates must be unitary. But there are many quantum gates which are also Hermitian. Hadamard gate is one of those quantum gates which are both unitary and Hermitian. Let's recall what that means. So, for unitary gate, we say that its inverse is equal to conjugate transpose. So let's say, so Hadamard is a unitary gate, so we can say Hadamard gate multiplied by conjugate transpose is equal to identity. That's the definition of unitary. So basically inverse of Hadamard gate is equal to its conjugate transpose. And what is conjugate transpose is that you take transpose and also you change sign of all the terms that have identity in it. And another thing is this, that Hadamard gate is also Hermitian. But Hermitian implies that Hadamard gate is equal to conjugate transpose. So Hadamard gate is equal to conjugate transpose. And if we combine both of those, then we can write that inverse of Hadamard gate is basically Hadamard gate. We don't have to take conjugate transpose, we can just say inverse of Hadamard gate is Hadamard gate by combining both of them. If this statement here is correct, then if I apply Hadamard gate on equal superposition of ket 0 and ket 1, I should get 0. Similarly, if I apply Hadamard gate on this equal superposition of ket 0 and ket 1, I should get ket 1. So let's try that if Hadamard gate is inverse of itself or not. So we apply Hadamard gate on this thing and see if we can get 1 or not. So we apply Hadamard gate on this one, which is ket 0 plus ket 1, minus ket 1 divided by square root of 2. And this is same as saying that I apply Hadamard gate on ket 0 divided by square root of 2, and I apply Hadamard gate on ket 1 divided by square root of 2. So basically I have taken this Hadamard gate inside because it's a linear operation. And then what will I have is that I expand this, so I will have here ket 0 plus ket 1, and I have here square root of 2. And also I have another square root of 2 here. Similarly, I will have minus. I will have here ket 0 minus ket 1 divided by square root of 2. And square root of 2, I can just write 2 here. So I just, maybe I should just write 2 here. So because square root of 2 times square root of 2 is 2. So, and now I simplify it further. I will have now 0 ket 0 plus ket 1 minus ket 0 plus ket 1 divided by 2, and ket 0 will cancel with ket 0. So I will, at the end, we'll have 2 times ket 1, because I have 2 ket 1s, divided by 2, and that is equal to ket 1, my final result. So I have shown that if I apply Hadamard gate on this, then I will get ket 0, and if I apply Hadamard gate on this, I will get ket 1. So this phase shift, which was previously looks odd, is very useful. It can distinguish between that if a result going to be ket 1 or ket 0. Although Hadamard gate is a single qubit gate, but we can extend it using tensor protect and can apply it on a multiple qubit quantum register. So let me clear the board, and then I will explain how to use Hadamard gate on multiple qubits.